Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back for the next episode of my little LP on Hypermine. Now, you probably won't recognize this place. I've done a bunch of building off camera just due to... I've kind of had this sore throat these last couple days, and I just sounded really bad, and I didn't want to record when I sounded that bad. But, yeah, like, I set up a new little house. We had a little... We were kind of squatting in this villager house for a while. I still need to transfer all my stuff over to our new place. But yeah, like, I picked this little area. I have my particles down to minimal, so we don't have to hear that annoying rain. But yeah, we're over here on an extreme hills biome because I'm kind of getting some inspiration on what I want to do and what I want to build or how I want to build it. Let's just tell him later. Oops, I spelt it all wrong. But yeah, this is what we've got so far. It's kind of in the shape of a shield, just because I'm going to kind of mess around with some builds like that, or I may see... I kind of have some ideas. I really can't explain it. I'd have to build it and show y'all. But yeah, this is our setup. We got a little bee chest going with a bunch of bee stuff, because we got a bunch of apiaries, and I'm working on getting some cultivated ones, just so we can start producing some more, like, beeswax and honey drops and stuff. So got a couple books to spawn and to the desert, which is like right over there, just so I can get some sand pretty easily. I'm that lazy. I mean, if I'm gonna play a mod pack with Mistcraft, I'm gonna be lazy. So yeah, and just a bunch of storage chest, blah 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 blah. And then what is this, you may be asking yourself? What is that? Well, y'all probably know what that is. But this is a liquid tesseract. Just typed a random number. Nothing illegal. But this is a Zycraft tank, and I filled it up with lava. Armitage set up a little community nether lava pump station, and that's where I'm currently getting all of my lava from. I guess we can go take a look real fast. Well, I do have my book with me, right? Yep. So, if we go ahead and hop over here. Boom, we can see here, here's my little liquid tesseract. You can already probably tell in the minimap that we are draining the heck out of the nether. Let's see, oh, it kind of goes away. Oh, there we go. Yeah, you can see nice little big square where the chunk loader stopped. But yeah, and that's my little liquid tesseract right there, a little liquid duck coming out of the pump. Magmatic engine powering itself off the lava it's pumping. So, oops, I can just go back to my house. That's Armitage's little setup. We're currently the only ones that are pumping lava. I chose to come this route just due to, in my last LP, I went with solar panels. Now, I covered this in the last episode on Hypermine, but if we take a look at this solar panel, it takes this, which takes this, which takes UU matter. And I don't get it. To get into the solar panels, you already have to have UU matter, which means you already have to have a matter fabricator, and that thing sucks so much power, and it's ridiculous. So obviously I can't do a bunch of these little dinky solar panels because they don't put out any power. I might as well go with like windmills or water mills at that point. So I chose to go the lava route. I've only got one geothermal generator set up right now with an MFE. Of course, later on down the road, we're probably going to want to transition to a different setup, like a bunch of geothermal generators supplying an MFSU or just something like that. And that this is just the other liquid tesseract pumping into the valve for the Zycraft tank. Let me know if you guys want to see a little tutorial on these. It's very similar to the iron tanks, which are already in Feed the Beast, but they're pretty cool. I like how they kind of glow, and you can actually make these a little bigger, and they can hold more lava. Like, Armitage has got a pretty cool one at his base. And this is my little smelting station. We have a centrifuge, just because I was centrifuging some of the honeycombs. Little induction smelter, electric furnace. Ooh, thank you. And I got a couple overclockers in there, just to help. A couple iron furnaces with nothing, just redstone in there to stop stuff from going in there from this. Or I had a pulverizer there before, and even though I set the configuration, it will still go into it. So, of course, these are powered with electrical engines. LV transformer go into this because I don't feel like paying for a transformer upgrade yet because they're pretty expensive. But yeah, well, we got rain going on right now, so these cats aren't really producing. Yeah, I got a bunch here. I'm probably going to get some more going. Ooh, cool. Let's go ahead and, oops, get that going. And take these. Cool, cool, cool. I'm missing a flower on both ends, but it doesn't have to be directly in front of them for it to work. So, yeah, this is kind of our setup. Let me show you the little area. Like, that's the desert I was talking about. But look at this. It's a nice little mountain range. I guess we can go ahead and try to get up to the top and have a look around. It's got a nice little valley on the other side. It's actually really nice. I thought about building there, but I kind of like how this is. I kind of like how big and open this is. Like, it's a nice little field. It's perfectly sized for like a nice big factory. So we're gonna have some fun with that. So over here is the little valley I was talking about. So yeah, the server's going great. We got a bunch of people on. We got a bunch of new people that came over from Zul'jin's little contest that he was holding to get some new members on the server. And this is the little valley I was talking about a little bit. And now these, y'all are going to have to let me know if y'all know what these holes are. It goes all the way down to bedrock. And I've noticed it a couple times in different places, so. Yeah, like this is another nice little area. My factory may have to be bigger than this, so I didn't know if I wanted to choose there. Breaking our ankles. So yeah, this is kind of the area I was talking about. I like it. It's really cool. I want to try to stay away from the redwood forest because those are just a notorious frame rate killer. I mean, I get pretty good frame rate. I usually stick at about 100 on FTB. But of course, when I'm recording, ooh, nice little cave, I lock my frame rate at 30 because YouTube is only 30 frames per second and there's no need in wasting the extra stress on my graphics card or anything like that just to, you know, be able to play at so much frame rate. So, and it just makes the video sizes a lot bigger, stuff like that, so. And this is another nice little valley. Like, it all kind of interconnects, and which is pretty cool. So it's really cool, but it's getting really close to that redwood forest. So I wanted to kind of stick away from it. But yeah, this is going to be our building area, and this is where we're going to build. And now this is a suggestion that somebody posted in the comments on my first Hypermind video, to be exact, for my LP. And he suggested making a ruby factory. Now, I guess let's go ahead and... Oh, I hope I don't get blown up by anything. So if we go ahead and take a look at rubies. And of course we're going to not be going for those. We're going to be going for these. Excuse me. So we can see... Let's see. Let's just take a look real fast. Implosion compressor. So we can make it from this ruby dust, which is all cool. So if we go ahead and take a look at the recipe on the ruby dust, we can of course smelt tools, blah 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 blah, and then we can also do redstone. Yeah, that's kind of one way. Let's see, recipe, where are the tiny piles? Right here. Centrifuge from a ruby comb. It gives you a tiny pile of ruby dust, which takes four of those tiny piles to make a whole pile. And of course we get that kind of stuff. So yeah, we're gonna get some ruby bees. They're pretty nifty. I think they're mediocrely hard to get. Do I have any food? Yep. It's gonna take a little bit of breeding and some practice and stuff like that, but that's what we're going to shoot for. We're going to shoot for ruby bees because we want to produce rubies. You know, because my name, Ruby. So, yeah, that's kind of our plan. It's still raining. I don't even know how long we've been recording, but it's been raining the whole time. So, yep, that's our plan so far. What is that? Oh, it's a pig. It looked like a lynx, but it's like, there ain't a jungle anywhere near here. So yeah, that's kind of where we're at, guys. And the sun's coming out. What a beautiful way to end this little segment. Oh, there's our house with no roof. I've had plenty of spiders jump in on me and come try to hang out because they'll trap me through the wall and climb up my walls. So Yeah, I'm not really sure where we should build the factory. Maybe here, or maybe over there in that other one, in that other little valley on the other side of the mountain there. I'm not 100% on that yet, so we'll just have to figure it out. I may go into creative and try to like kind of mock up some designs, but I also thought how cool it would be to kind of like inset our factory into this mountain. Like if we can choose which valley we're going to build in, and then kind of inset the whole factory into it. So like all that's coming out of the mountain are like support beams and maybe like a big huge red sign or something like that that just kind of designates what it is. And maybe we'll have like a big like flourishing town out here. I don't know. I think we can come up with some pretty cool stuff. I may mock up some designs that maybe look cool for it, and maybe we can move forward from there. But what we're going to do in this episode is we're going to go set some stuff up for spawn. Originally I had planned on doing this with Bodog, but he just left for Florida for 2 weeks, and we really need a grinder so that people can get experience and enchant some stuff. So I'm going to cut. I'm going to try to get somebody to come along with me, and maybe we can do a little dual comm and set up the skeleton grinder. So I'll see you guys in a sec. Alright guys, so we're back, and I have Fluent Chaos and Zul'jin with me, and we're going to be setting up the we're going to be setting up the skeleton grinder. So I've already given them some resources. We have a bunch in this chest that I grinded out. I got some melee turtles, I got the soul shard, soul cages of course, and then the wireless receiver and transmitter so that we can turn it off if we please. So this is the spot we picked out. We picked it next to the Iron Golem farm because I figure what I'll probably end up doing is maybe getting rid of some of this water. And this will be our mob area. Since that's a grinder, we'll put all the other grinders in this area. Because Lone Wolf has also got a tier 5 Cal shard already. So
right. And we can also feed these into extra dimensional barrels.
Correct.
You know? It'll be good.
Oh, because we have a blaze farm too. So that shouldn't be a problem. So I guess let's go ahead and I got 5 melee turtles. So what we're going to do is make this. Did I already count this right? Nope, it's 6. Okay, so we can't count. That's confirmed. So what we're going to go ahead and do is make this 5 wide.
All right, glad I could help, guys. I'm out.
No. Yay. Too close.
So let's see.
And just to let you guys know, these, they're nailing creative. It's just my texture pack doesn't show what's in their hands for some strange reason.
Oh.
Oh, really?
I don't know.
That's weird. Yeah. Oh, that's right. You're using the 64-bit faithful, huh?
Yeah. Lone Wolf will have to look at that for me if you can.
Are we just doing layers here and I'll start slamming these
down? I'm putting down a little platform. We're going to make this platform not too big. We'll probably stop it here. And now this is going to be a, it's going to come up to, how far am I going to have to count up? Because they have to fall 22 blocks for the skeletons to be half a heart. Now, yeah, granted, right. The melee turtles do 2 hearts of damage, I believe. Or maybe more than that if you don't have armor. So it's going to be kind of overkill, but this way they won't get backed up on the turtles, and they won't have trouble killing them down. So,
that's cool.
So let's go ahead and go up 22 blocks from this little platform right here that I'm standing on.
Okay.
All right, the whole back side here that we're on?
Yep.
Okay.
So it'll be 2, 3, 4, 8, 9, 10.
You'll measure for me. Oh. Can't get on the post.
Alright, I think I got 22.
Christ. Thank you.
I'll just take it over for you. How about that?
I miss my grab chest from the old server.
Yeah. I miss my quantum from the old server. Well, at least it wasn't the one I was on. The last Hypermine. So is that about 22-ish, Fluent? Were you counting?
Are we there? No, I was following your lead.
Y'all are
don't
trusting
me.
Charge
accounting.
All right. Let's just make sure.
Kills me in Tusk there.
Let's see. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. Okay, we're one high.
Aha.
Oh. All right, so Zul'jin's got a jetpack, so but we don't, so
no.
We're going to be kind of stuck here. So now what we need to do is make this 9 wide. We need to make it even, though. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? No, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so we need to make this 1 wider. Yeah, there you go.
Like that?
And now we need to make this going back 9. So 1, 2,
got it.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Good job, Jim.
Actually, one more back. Yeah, Zul'jin's going to be supervising. He's...
I'm going to help a little bit.
That was a good 9.
All right, so let's go ahead and fill this in.
Oh.
Yep. So this is kind of our base spawning platform. And
got
now,
it.
Let's see, we went back one. Now we need to, what do we do? So let's go ahead and build these walls up too high.
Right.
They don't see stuff in your hands.
Really? Do you have Optifine installed?
Yeah.
Hmm.
I have the ultimate version. Maybe that's why.
I don't know. That's weird, though.
It is weird.
I don't know. I don't have Optifine installed, just so I can... So it won't mess with my single-player stuff. So, you got that bucket of water?
I do.
Alright, put it in that corner real fast.
Oh.
I just want to see something. Shit. Okay. So we need to do this the old-fashioned way. All right, go ahead and pick up your bucket of water. All right, so we need to... So that. Right? I think.
Still don't push the talk, huh?
Me?
Mm-hmm.
No, I think I just have my voice activation up a little higher. Am I cutting out?
Well, no, but like the white noise disappears.
Ah, yeah.
Let me out.
So, okay, if you put a bucket here. Okay, if you put a bucket of water on this corner, in that corner, up one more Z, never mind. Oh, you got it. Yeah. Okay, cool. So y'all see what's going on here.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
All right. So let's go ahead and pick up those buckets of water, cause I'm stuck. I'm not gonna be able to move. And I don't want to kill y'all's water source blocks. So. Alright, cool. So now they'll kind of skirt this way. Which is good. So. What we need is a... exit. Right there. Cool. And that'll be good. So then they'll come out here. And start falling. So we need to... Hmm. I guess let's go ahead and... I should have brought some ladders. So let's go ahead and bring this so we can get back up easy. But I guess we can go ahead and finish up here first.
So we're just breaking this all down?
Yeah, we're going to break that down. I figure we can go ahead and finish up here first, though. Now let's, you got both those buckets of water, or you just got one?
Got the one. Need Z to complete the deal.
Coming!
Did you run out of power?
Yes. Hold on. A couple more laps around this ice and I should be good to fly up there.
That's awesome.
It's kind of like you're the friend with the old car. Well, hold on, let me just turn it over a couple more times. It'll start or something.
This ghetto ass Orma, I can't wait to have my gravity chest plate back. All right, I'm on top now. Where do I go?
Oh, come in the side. There's a hole. Come in, right here. Oh, yeah, or you can make a hole. That's cool. Alright, so...
How often do you forget that you're playing Minecraft and you can move anything?
So, what we need to do is put a water source block in this corner on the second level. Yep. Alright, cool. And everything's flowing cool. Alright, so cool. We can go ahead... Oh, we got a leak, but... Y'all go ahead and come on out here. I'm just gonna close that up for now. Hopefully that... Does that destroy books? Oh, I didn't get to the book. Okay.
Ooh.
We're good. So, now let's go ahead and... What we're gonna do... Oh, I might run out of brick, but... We're gonna bring this wall down, and then as we go down, we're gonna put marble on both sides.
Alright, which wall are you standing on?
So, like, as we go down... We're going to put brick on both sides.
We go down the middle and we lay on the left and right as we go down.
Yep.
Kapishki. Is there a... What's the hole for? Is that just a missed block? Or?
Yeah, I think that was a missed block.
And what's the technical purpose behind this?
Looking good up there, buddy.
Yep, it's coming.
Looking grinderish.
It looks like a big old chimney. Do you have any red weenies that we could roast?
I guess we could put some glass in it, but...
We probably need to do some... We could do pixel art skeleton.
Oh, yeah.
Not big on pixel art, but I know some people like it.
Been trying
nothing
lately.
Cheesy. Nothing cheesy is all. Okay, so turtles in the back?
Yeah.
Like, do I have to worry about where I lay this? Can you pick a turtle up pretty easily?
Yeah.
So is that the general idea, or is it going to be every other...
Yeah, it's just the wrong way. They need to come the other way. Right. Cool. Turtle power.
So, do you have to right-click on each one and type run or load program or?
Yeah, I'm gonna program them here in a second.
There's actually I don't know if y'all met him yet. Woolly Creeper had a turtle program installed for the other server that we can upload to the programs. That way, it'll just be an auto start every time the server loads up. Right now, we can do it manually, but sooner or later, we can get it to where it's loaded into the server. That way, when we get restarts on the server, the turtles just automatically go into the correct programming.
Yeah.
Nice.
Y'all can break it now.
Somebody.
Y'all can break it. Alright, I'm gonna go put the soul shard in. Wish me luck.
Insert luck. Coin to begin game.
I want to let you know we're all counting on you.
Thanks.
I see. Just get a warm up. I don't really have to change up setup. I told you all my camouflage doesn't work correctly.
Yeah, and Z's on another lap.
I think I need to change my my transparency and attitude. I don't know. Maybe I don't
am I supposed
camouflage.
To not see your arms right now?
It's on, then.
Or am I?
Watch.
Well, oh, no. I. Okay.
Let me turn it. I'll show you.
Nice.
No arms.
It's like you stuffed your arms in your shirt.
Is that a arm in your shirt? Or are you just happy to see me?
I'm gonna wear a jacket out here. This is the what is this? Oh, this is the Taiga.
Taiga.
Oh, I didn't put the damn thing in.
Ruby.
Hold on, I gotta come back down anyways.
This pillar building is like breathtaking footage, dude.
All right, asshole. Oh, I need.
I stole your blocks. You did.
I didn't do anything. Just hold on a sec.
Arrows.
Oh.
Ow.
I'm drowning. I can't swim. God. Help me.
Ruby,
help me.
On,
help. All right. Yeah. Wait till I drown.
What are we supposed to do? I don't know the crafting recipe. Be for a life preserver.
I don't think those are in this mod pack.
Ooh. Oh man, right. Sweet. Right? What is that? Ooh. Just a sideways repeater? Or what the hell?
Oh, that is a wireless transmitter. That's so I can wirelessly transmit a signal up here to turn the soul cage off. Because with tier 5 soul cages, you can turn it on and off. So that you don't get overspawns.
Yeah. Got it.
Yeah.
Things wicked. I'm impressed by the smallest things right now, no doubt.
Everything's impressive. I want a handgun. Did you see the handgun yet? In this
they got
box?
A handgun?
Yeah. Dude, they got a pistol.
Is that Sidecraft that gives it to you? Or?
I forget. Let me see if I can find it.
All right, hey, if y'all flip that switch.
Messing around with the handgun. Flip the switch?
Yeah, flip the switch real fast.
Hunter's handgun. That's what it's called. It's like a six shooter.
Oh, yeah, what is the leg? Oh, there we go. Okay, I'm glad it didn't lag on your end.
Oh my god!
What?
I got shot.
I'm getting some epic shots.
I'm done after this. I'm getting off.
I'll just stand there and catch him.
Oh my god, I'm dead.
Dude! Oh, they look like strong arms, don't they?
Oh, my bed was obstructed. Hold on.
He's all over me, man. He's all over me.
Let me put you back, dude.
Hey, no, I'm here.
Are you good?
Okay. Yeah, there's a book that's at spawn.
Some stuff to toss at you here. Got some potatoes.
Yeah.
The button.
Drop your Doritos.
Doritos. G.I. Joe arm. That's your arrow. Oh, I'm still throwing your stuff at you. You left.
Yeah, my bad. I accidentally clicked on the book.
Oh, nice suit.
Thank you.
Yeah. That's dapper.
I'm glad you're the only one who's ever noticed. Zul'jin's never commented on my suit.
The Baton Rouge threads I don't deal with, dude.
Alright, you got my stuff?
What else are you missing here? Let me see.
A pick.
I don't
and a chest plate.
The pick. The chest band, I don't have that, so we gotta figure out where that went. The agua.
Do you have stuff, Z?
I'm sorry, I was joking. What did you say?
Do you have a chest plate and a pick?
I have carrots. You want some carrots?
Oh, hey.
I don't have a chest plate colder? Or a pick, buddy.
Colder? Oh, warmer? A little warmer.
Warmer? Oh, back. Back.
Oh.
It slid on the ice.
Wow. Alright, well, I need my pick. Ooh. Oh, man, where's my pick?
Oh, there we go. Okay.
Check it out, dude. See. It's like...
Brush the ice, man. It's curling. We can,
wait, I see my pick. Curling.
Oh my god.
There's gotta be something that looks like a brush in this mod that you could you could pull something.
NEI. BRUSH. Oh, paintbrushes, but you can't do them. You can't use them.
Alright, let me try to not die this time.
Alright. Are you gonna go up there, dude?
Alright, wish me luck.
Good luck. It's the third stack of brick.
Get that bucket of water on you? Here, I'll just do this for the time being. You get shot off, I hug the pillar. Wow. Ridiculous.
Is it a lot of skellies yet?
Oh, yeah. Yes. Pretty crazy. Not bad.
Got a goldie and everything.
Alright, cool. Well, I appreciate the help, guys. I gotta do some research, and I gotta get the turtle set up. And go program some stuff. And then I think we'll have us a fully working skeleton grinder. And what I'll, Whoop, lag. Okay, there we go. They all stopped moving.
Stop. Hammer time.
That's pretty much what it was like. But, yeah, so do you guys want to go ahead and call this here and I'll do the programming and y'all can come see it later? Or do you want me to do it now and... We finish this video
good to me,
off,
man.
Right?
Ah, it sounds good.
Okay, cool.
No, all right, I'm already impressed.
Yeah, so I appreciate the help placing blocks Zul'jin for supervising. I appreciate it. And helping a little bit. Yeah. So, thanks, guys, and I'll let y'all know when it's ready.
Welcome.
Awesome.
All right, later, guys.
Peace.
Peace.
Hey, guys, I'm back. Hopefully you... Ooh, we got a creeper up there. Hopefully you enjoyed that little tricom with Z and Fluent Chaos. So, what we're going to go ahead and do now is we're going to go ahead and... Ooh, later, Vamp. We're going to go ahead... I'm really afraid that creeper's going to drop on my head. I'm really afraid he is. But I guess we'll see. What is with the sky? That's weird looking. I don't know if y'all be able to see that in recording or not. But... Yeah, I don't know, that creeper's sketching me out. So what we're going to go ahead and do is we're going to edit the program. Now, turtles have this thing called startup. What the startup does is that it'll run this code as soon as the turtle boots up. So that means anytime you leave the chunk and you come back, or if the server reboots, for instance. So we're going to go ahead and edit it. And I've already kind of prepared a script. So we're going to go ahead and write this out. So we're doing a while true do. And we're going to do turtle.attack and for I. I'm going to go back in and explain what all this does just here in a second. Just getting it all typed out real fast. It's weird. I'm so used to there's kind of lag like when you type in the turtle. So it's kind of weird. So yeah, it's kind of laggy, but yep, there we go. It's pretty much done. So what this is doing, let me just make sure I got it right real fast. Yep. Okay, so let's explain it real fast. So I don't know if you guys know this, but I'm a programmer. That's what I do. That's how I pay the bills. how I pay for where I live. And this code is really different from what I do. I do a C-oriented programming language. Most of you probably won't know what that means, but C is a lot different than Lua, which this is. So, this first line, it says, while true, do. Now, this is considered a Boolean value, so true and false is true. And since we're not assigning any variable to check if it's true, it says while true do, and it's just defaultly one. So it's always going to do this, and it's always going to keep doing it and keep doing it and keep doing it over and over. So while true do, and then it's doing turtle attack. So it's just going to attack right by it. And then it's going into a for. Now this has, what it's doing is that it's going for I equals 1, and then all the way up to 5. It says do this. And now if we look down here, skeletons, I believe, will only drop like 2 items, maybe 3. So we'll kind of see. I'm leaving a little buffer room in case they drop armor, but people will always kind of be standing here, so they'll probably pick the armor up in case it drops a couple pieces of armor or anything like that. So this does, while this is true, yeah, and then it does if the item count, so as in, as it goes through inventory slots 1 through 5, it's getting the item count. And if it's 0, then it's not doing anything. But if it's greater than 0, which means if there's an item in here, then it's going to select whatever number it's on, because we're doing I equals 1, and it's incrementing the 1, or the I, I'm sorry. And then it's doing select this inventory slot, whatever it is. So if it was on 4 up here, then it's going to select 4, and then it's going to drop down. That just means it's going to drop the item downwards. And we're going to have either transposers or chest under here. I haven't quite figured that out yet. It's going to drop it down, then it's going to stop, and then it's going to end the for, and then it's going to end the while. And then this whole script will keep running and running and running and running for as long as it can. So that's just going to get us hooked up. So I'm going to go ahead and save. What is going on? Is the server lagging or... saved. Okay, there we go. And exit. So now if we go ahead and type startup, and as you can see, it's not ending and prompting us for another command. So now if I was to get close enough to the turtle, boom, he's hitting us. And if I was to die or drop any items, he would drop the stuff down. Now there's no chest under there yet, or any transposers or anything like that yet. So we're not going to turn the mob spawning on just yet. But what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to go ahead and cut, and I'm going to copy the script over to the rest of these turtles and kind of get those going, and just so we have it ready. And then we're going to make a couple changes to the building. I may kind of summarize it, kind of hurry up and do the glass and stuff like that. And I kind of need to set this whole area up. I think I might kind of take charge on getting the mob grinder set up and everything, like Lone Wolf set up that iron farm over there. So we got plenty of iron probably. And this whole little lake kind of area is going to be our grinders. Lone Wolf also has been grinding away, and he's got a tier 5 cow shard. So I'm going to get with him and see what he wants to do about that. See if he wants to maybe record us setting it up or something like that. Or if he just wants me to just go ahead and set it up. Or if he wants to set it up, we'll just kind of have to see. So I'm going to go ahead and cut. I'm going to fill these turtles out, and I'll be back with you guys. Hey guys, I'm back. And a couple things have changed. Still didn't do the glass. It is probably never going to get done. So I've been sitting here kind of just watching a podcast and trying to figure the whole problem out. So a problem that I was having... Is that guy really there? No, it was like... So a problem that I was having is when the turtles were right here and the mobs were landing on these blocks right here, the mob could land on the very the very outside of the block, like on the very edge of the furthest away from the turtle, and the turtle couldn't reach them. And I kind of thought about it and thought about it and tried to think of some ways I could fix it. There was the water method, but considering the mobs were dropping from up there, the turtles would take longer to clean them out, and we would end up with like kind of a backlog of skeletons. So it really didn't make sense to go that route. So then I dropped them onto the turtles, and it seems to work a lot better. Sometimes they kind of get stuck on the turtles, but it's nothing too major, so that's working a lot better. But then I had to solve the whole issue of what are they going to do with the items. I tried, you know, just hooking up Buildcraft pipes. Of course, that didn't work. So let me show you the system that I have. Let's just hop on down here. And so what's going on is that we have a sequencer. It's set to 1 second. I'm about to set this to actually a quarter of a second, because I was testing some stuff and it didn't need to run that fast. So these are all iron chests, of course, because you can put them right next to each other. And then we have a transposer under all of these. The transposer is getting some electrical power, or not electrical, but redstone power from the sequencer. The sequencer is running at a quarter of a second, red alloy wire across all of these with pneumatic tubes connected to all of them. Pneumatic tube snakes up here and then goes up there. So let me get up there real fast. And I'm going to, of course, close all this in. I got to pretty all this stuff up real fast. But I figured, ooh, look at all this XP. Let's just grab it real fast before it despawns. So, and then that's the little snake that we saw. So then it comes up, it tries to go into these barrels, and if it can't, like for example, if it's a piece of armor or if it's a bow, it's not going to go in there. And now if we didn't have this chest right here, those transposers would get clogged up. I actually ran into that issue, and I totally forgot. Oh yeah. Well, since it's pneumatic tubes, if the bow is trying to be sent somewhere, and it can't be, and it's not even going to send it because they're smart like that. So you have to give the transposer a place to send those damaged bows or non-bones and non-arrow items. So I just have a little gold chest right here. It's probably plenty big. Honestly, this could probably be hooked up to something else that would maybe take these bows and do something with them. Like, I don't know, like smelt them or something, or just something to get rid of them, or throw them through a recycler or something like that, because I guess you can always kind of use it and craft them and repair them, but I'd have to think of a way to do that automatically. So but yeah, the system's working pretty well now, getting some nice XP. There's still a couple changes I want to make to this. I don't feel like it's very optimized that well. And I think they're getting kind of clogged up top. So if we go take a look up there real fast. Let's just hop on up. Whoa, crazy lag. See, look, you can hear them. I don't know how well y'all can hear that. But see, they're getting clogged. So I maybe need to possibly expand this room by one on each side, and then maybe make the little exit thing like 2 blocks wide or 3 blocks wide or something, because that tier 5 shard puts out so many skeletons. See, now the design I used is kind of a vanilla style mob farm, and the vanilla spawners wouldn't put out enough skeletons to really kind of do this, where they kind of get into a traffic jam, if you will. So yeah, some things definitely need to get changed. I'm not going to be able to do that in this episode though, because it is now about 2 a.m. and I still have to edit this video and get it uploaded for you guys on Saturday. So I'm probably going to work on this a little bit off camera, probably work on it tomorrow after the LP episode comes out. I would like to start releasing maybe the LP episodes a little sooner. Of course, it's not going to be as delayed as the time between my first Hypermine LP episode to the last Hypermine LP episode, because that was just due to we were getting a new server, we had to get established. I mean, everybody's seen the, you know, general getting ready stuff a million times, so I didn't want to bore y'all with that, and it's just, I don't know, it's just something I don't see that needs to be recorded. So yep, I need to fix this traffic jam. That's on the to-do list. It'll probably be fixed by just expanding this room a little bit and then making the exit bigger. So that's where we're currently at with the spawner. I'm happy with it. I'm happy we got it all fixed up. And I knew that was about to happen. So much lag. So I'm going to go ahead and call this episode good. And let me know what you guys thought. Maybe y'all know some better ways to grab those items from these turtles or something like that. And I'll catch you guys later. Hey guys, what's up? Hopefully you enjoyed that video. It was a long one, huh? So on the left, you're going to find my tutorial in the coke oven. On the right, you're going to find my latest tutorial on all the tesseracts. Later, guys.